We welcome you once again to our Wonderful Day in the Lord broadcast. We're working through a little series here on a word from the Lord. And each day we're looking at a particular word, either a biblical term, word, or concept that's found in Scripture that really is of extreme value to us in our spiritual life. Our word yesterday was depravity, which is the idea of moral and complete corruption of our very nature. We were born sinners. We can do nothing to make ourselves right before God. And all that leads to the things that Jesus Christ had to do for us so that we could be right before Him. So we're going to look at some of those kinds of words in the next few days. The first of those types of words, these very positive words that tell us what Christ has done, that I want to look at is the word redemption. It's not necessarily a common word in our secular language. We do use that word occasionally, but we probably have a different understanding of it than the biblical terminology. So I want to read 1 Peter, chapter 1, verses 18 and 19, and where we find this word. It says, knowing that you were not redeemed, there is our word, redeemed, our redemption, not redeemed with corruptible things like silver or gold from your futile conduct inherited from your forefathers, but with the precious blood as of a lamb unblemished and spotless, the blood of Christ. So let's start with this word redemption. And in the New Testament, there's three different words translated redeemed or redemption. And I have often taught this over the years that I think these three words give us the full package and understanding of what it means to be redeemed. The background of this word comes out of the slave market. The Jewish people knew something of slavery, and there was a redemption process there among the Jewish people in the Old Testament. In the New Testament, we have the Greeks and Romans that knew much about the slave market, and they understood what redemption meant there. So I'm going to go with those two contexts and look at these three words that help us understand the meaning. The first word and the principal word is agorazo. An agorazo means to buy out or to buy. And so if you picture a slave market in ancient times, someone goes down to the slave market and there are slaves being sold. In ancient times, it wasn't like the American system exactly. Many of these slaves or people who were being sold into slavery had been captured in war. Some had sold themselves into slavery because of financial situations and so forth, but they would be sold to a master. And the master would go out and buy that slave, and that's the word agorazo. Spiritually speaking, then, we are purchased. We're purchased by Christ. The second word is ex agorazo, which means out of. And so we're bought out of the slave market of sin. So we have a slave, and someone goes down to the auction, buys the slave, and brings him out of the slave market and takes him home to be his own. And that's the word ex agorazo. Spiritually speaking, we're not only purchased, but we're purchased out of the slave market of sin, so that sin is no longer our domain. It is no longer our master. We have been purchased by another and taken home. And then there's a final word, latruo, which means to set free. And so a slave could be bought by a master. He could be taken out of the slave market. And the master now has every right to do with that slave whatever he wants to do. And that slave, the master, could set the slave free. And so that slave who was once in the slave market, belonging to a master, has now been brought out and set free. And so we now, spiritually speaking, have been set free to be servants and followers of a new master, the Lord Jesus Christ. The Lord didn't save us to set us free in the sense of living out our own life independent of Him, but now we're under His leadership, His mastery. We belong to Him. And that's what this passage here is saying in verse 19 in particular. But with the precious blood, we have been redeemed with the precious blood. Of course, that's a reference to the blood of Christ. As a lamb unblemished and spotless, the blood of Christ. And so the purchase price for our slavery, our spiritual slavery, is the precious blood of Jesus Christ that was shed for us to take us out of the slave market of sin and set us free to follow Him. And so redemption is a beautiful picture of what the Lord had to do to set us free from the bondage and enslavement of sin that we all were born into. But now, because of Jesus Christ, we have been set free to follow Him and for Him to be our loving and glorious Master. Redemption is a wonderful word. It's a word to contemplate today as we think about a word from the Lord. We'll talk about justification tomorrow. Thank you.